Welcome to this week's show. You're listening to Ross Harper on Adger. This is my weekly down-tempo, chill, whatever else kind of show. Whatever I'm feeling like. This one's called Filling in the Ghostly Gaps with Real Concrete. Great name. Thank you. Okay, so filling in the gaps with real concrete. Filling in the ghostly gaps with real concrete was by M422. We're now in Twilight of Ages. It's by Mar.io, and this is the Mar.io remix of his own track. Listening to Ross Harper on Adja. This is my weekly show. I also do a monthly show. The next one's on Monday. And in that one I play more of a menagerie of, I guess, dance floor focused beats, but not really. Just it's my new music show. So I just play, again, whatever I'm enjoying at that moment. Thank you. taken my slippers off now. Things are getting serious.
Yes, boy.
Okay, we had King Gizzard and the Lizard, and it was the remix of Blue Morpho, CL's Fluttering dub. And then we had Tussie Deluxe, Elysium, the Elysium remix, the original by POTS. And we're now into Helios Fan by Aphex Twin. You don't know the story behind this music. Aphex Twin, his dad was a miner, and he worked down the mine with his dad to earn enough money to buy some synthesizers. I think he was a teenager at the time, and so he had kind of like a few synthesizers and drum machines, and spent his time as a teenager making music. And this is from the Ambient Works 85 to 92 album. And so there was a load of these tracks that he made, but he just kind of recorded them to cassette tape. There is a kind of rumor, I don't know if it's true, that a cat weed on a load of these cassette tapes, and so they were kind of slightly damaged, but at some point they were sifted through, and the kind of standout tracks were remastered and released on R&S Records. That was I guess back in the 90s. But funnily, like, even though I'm a 90s raver, started raving in 95, actually I only came to this Ambient Works album quite late, I think in about 2015, can you believe that? I mean, obviously I'd heard the tracks around, but it's a funny old world. I was quite caught up in my own music for a good kind of 15 years. I kind of neglected the world. Thank you. Okay, we had After Helios Fan by Aphex Twin, we had Oak by Ludwig AF, which is on a kind of tribute album that he did for the ambient works by Aphex Twin. In fact, I've got a few artists, including me, who have made tribute albums to that particular collection of works. Mine is the Ambient Girl, my Ambient Girl albums. After that we had The Field, Soft Numbers IV, which is 4 in Roman numerals, and we've just come out of Cluster Lizard, the Drop Reflects the Ocean in Itself. I'll let you think about that. And we're now into Avogadro Combat, Sunset Strip. Thank you. Avocado Combat, Sunset Strip. I love that track. We had Coyote, As Above. Love that track as well. And then we just come out of Liquido, Tunnel of Love. And that was actually his kind of tribute to Aphex Twin's Ambient Works 85 to 92. Which, you know, that's pretty incredible, isn't it? All these tributes to a teenager making music in his bedroom. Okay, and we're now in Solar Society HAL 03, which is from Genau Unlimited, which is an Italian label based in Torino in Italy. And they release a lot of techno music, but they also have some chill out stuff, which is released on Genau Unlimited. Genau is the kind of techno side of things. Genau Unlimited is the kind of down tempo side of things. And this one, Solar Society, I think I'm right in thinking it's the label owner who with a couple of other dudes, and they've just kind of jammed in a studio for a few days and came up with this EP. So this is HAL 03 from that EP. And the guy that runs the label, his name's Gandalf. I don't know, I'm guessing that's his artist name, but maybe his parents called him Gandalf. Of course, Gandalf from Lord of the Rings, a man after my own heart. And interesting story, you might think Gandalf might be a strange birth name to give to someone, but I recently had a Christmas party and I ended up with a couple of guys attending. One of their names was Noah, not too rare, quite rare. I love the name Noah, really love that. And his friend's name was Safe, S-A-F-E, and that was his birth name, Safe. And I knew it was going to be a really good party when, you know, Noah and Safe turned up. I kind of, you know you're going to have a good party when Noah and Safe turn up.
Yeah.
Okay, I didn't want to talk in that last track because it's just very emotional. So that last one was Ostra, I'm a Monster. I found Ostra a few years ago. An advert, I think, popped up on my Facebook feed, and I followed it, and I found Ostra. And by the time I found her, I think she'd put out 3 albums. And she started producing electronic music as a teenager in her bedroom as well, on Ableton Live though, not on hardware like Aphex Twin. By the way, we've got another Aphex Twin track in the background from the Ambient Works 85 to 92 album. This one's Tha, T-H-A. Anyway, back to Ostra. She started playing with Ableton Live, which is a kind of music production suite. But she was a classically trained opera singer. And she started creating electronic music using her operatic voice, but also with what's kind of known as channeled lyrics. So she would just kind of write whatever was coming into her mind. And she has just created some of the most incredible heartfelt electronic music. I think she went through a bit of a bumpy patch a couple of years ago, around COVID. She signed to Domino, which are a big independent label that are owned by a major, I think. So she kind of sold her soul to them and put out an album with them, which didn't do as well as her previous albums. And this happens a lot, right? You know, an artist becomes successful, inverted commas, gets picked up by a major, and then there's a lot of pressure to continue to be successful, and the pressure for a dear artist is too much. And I'm filling in the blanks, but I really felt from her that she struggled with that album on Domino, and she's kind of gone quite quiet after that. But that can be healthy, and I'm hoping that there'll be a re-emergence. I think there is already a re-emergence. But Ostra, A-U-S-T-R-A. If you haven't listened to all of her first 4 albums, go away and listen to them, and come back and report back to me on my Instagram in my messages once you have. Thank you. I thought I'd end on a couple of my kind of chill tracks. We just came out of Rushing from the Ambient Girl album. David Lynch liked that. Flattering, hey? Well, at least the David Lynch fan club on Instagram used it in one of their Instagram stories. But I think David Lynch might be behind that Instagram. I can't be sure. Maybe not. And we're now in First Light, which is another one of mine. This is the chill mix of First Light. So I hope you've enjoyed this down-tempo chill. And see you next week.